morning, everyone.
Bonjour à tous.
Dès le début de la crise, notre gouvernement a annoncé un plan pour mobiliser le secteur industriel de façon à ce qu'on puisse produire rapidement, ici au Canada, les articles dont on a besoin. Depuis, des entreprises d'un bout à l'autre du pays se portent volontaires pour nous aider et, chaque semaine, on réalise des progrès importants. Je veux donc commencer aujourd'hui en faisant une mise à jour. D'abord, on a signé un contrat avec GL Chemtech d'Oakville pour assurer l'approvisionnement en produits chimiques qui sont essentiels au dépistage. Alors qu'on commence à reprendre certaines activités, on doit resserrer d'autres mesures, comme le dépistage et la recherche de contacts. On doit donc faire en sorte que nos professionnels de la santé possèdent les bons outils pour administrer plus de tests et les analyser. We also signed two new contracts to make sure our frontline workers can continue to do their jobs safely. Joseph Ribkoff, a clothing manufacturer based out of Dorval, will be providing us with 1.2 million made-in-Canada medical gowns, with deliveries starting in July. And the Stevens Company, a medical supply distributor in Brampton, will be supplying 15 million shoe covers, as well as 5 million disinfectant wipes, all made in Canada. Over the past few months, our government has helped companies retool their manufacturing facilities and massively scale up production to meet the demands of this crisis. I want to thank every entrepreneur and every worker who's stepped up to contribute to this fight. As we start to reopen and some people head back to work, the need for personal protective equipment and other essential supplies like hand sanitizer and disinfectant will continue to grow. We're making sure we're ready for that. On Saturday, a ship carrying 160,000 liters of hand sanitizer arrived in Vancouver, and we're expecting seven more ships with hand sanitizer in the coming days. We also have almost a million face shields and more than 7 million pairs of gloves on their way to the provinces and territories. And to connect businesses looking for PPE with suppliers, today we're launching a PPE Supply Hub website. We also created new, innovative procurement streams to allow more businesses to develop solutions and products Canadians need because of this pandemic. We've always known that Canada is home to some of the best innovators in the world, and it's been great to see so many of them use their talent and know-how to help our communities during this crisis. In April, we put out a call asking for creative, made-in-Canada prototypes that will help current and future outbreaks of COVID-19 and similar public health emergencies. And in just 2 weeks, we received over 550 proposals. We will soon be selecting some prototypes for testing, and innovators will be able to work with the government to scale up production. Après avoir passé plusieurs mois chez nous, la vie commence tranquillement à reprendre son cours. Il faut évidemment demeurer très vigilant et continuer à suivre les directives des autorités sanitaires, mais certains commerces peuvent commencer à rouvrir, et ça, c'est une bonne nouvelle. Les boutiques de quartier, les petites entreprises et les commerçants jouent un rôle essentiel dans nos communautés et on s'est ennuyé d'eux pendant le confinement. Et c'est le temps de les encourager autant que possible, tout en faisant attention et portant un masque si nécessaire. La reprise présente plusieurs défis pour les propriétaires d'entreprises. Après avoir fermé leurs portes pendant plusieurs mois, nombreux sont ceux qui ont du mal à reprendre leurs activités et à réembaucher leurs employés parce qu'ils éprouvent des problèmes de liquidité. Over the past few weeks, as businesses get ready to reopen, more employers are using the Canada Emergency Wage Subsidy to rehire their employees. Just take Track and Trail in Edmonton. Track and Trail was well established in the community, selling outdoor clothing, equipment, and footwear for 36 years. When the pandemic hit, they had to close down their stores. After a number of challenging months, they're now ready to welcome customers again. And as part of getting their shops back up and running, they used the wage subsidy to help rehire their employees. Shops, local entrepreneurs, and business owners are the backbone of our economy. They make our towns and cities better places to call home. and collectively, they are the largest employer in the country. As we start to reopen, some businesses will need support to get back on their feet, and our government will be there to help with programs like the emergency wage subsidy. I also want to remind people that we launched a hotline service to help entrepreneurs and small business owners, including not-for-profit organizations and charities, navigate these uncertain times. People with pressing financial needs can now call 1-866-989-1080 to speak with an accountant or a business advisor. Je veux terminer ce matin en rappelant à tous les gens d'affaires qu'on a lancé une ligne téléphonique pour vous aider à naviguer cette période incertaine. Les entrepreneurs et les petites entreprises, y compris les organismes de bienfaisance et les organismes à but non lucratif, pourront maintenant composer le 1-866-989-1080 pour obtenir l'aide d'un comptable ou d'un conseiller financier. During this pandemic, our government has been there for Canadians every step of the way, and we will continue to propose measures to support them. On Saturday, we shared draft legislation with the opposition parties, which included additional proposals to help people. This legislation will aim to provide direct support to people with disabilities, support more workers through the wage subsidy, and ensure that Canadians who aren't able to meet certain judicial timelines, such as bankruptcy, aren't unfairly punished. We will also strive to make CERB payments more flexible, while making sure that those who knowingly and wrongfully claim the CERB face consequences. Discussions are ongoing, but I fully expect us to be able to work well with the opposition to deliver this important support to Canadians. Les prochaines semaines s'annoncent chargées alors qu'on commence à reprendre certaines activités. Mais comme toujours, vous pouvez compter sur notre gouvernement pour la suite des choses. Merci beaucoup.